Hey everyone, this is Fyers Trivedi and welcome back. In this video, I'll be discussing about how we can create a NSE open interest Excel sheet using Fyers One, the soft terminal, and get a live data of NSE and Banknifty open interest sheet. What we have been using with the NSE data, but it has some lagging and connection errors, so we can use it. Whoever have a Fyers ID, they can use and create the same sheet with it. So first of all, how you can download? If you are a Fyers user, you can download using just type in Google like Fyers One and click on the download. Once you click on this link, go to the trading platform and utility and click on the Fyers One terminal. There you go. This is the link. Click on the link and the download will start. Once you're done downloading, just set up the installation, open the file and run the program using your Fyers login ID, username, password, and that's it. So then you will have a Fyers One terminal. You will need to make few changes in your computer to run and create a link file to this Excel. First of all, just type in Excel, go to the location folder. Click on the Excel, right click on it, go to properties, compatible settings, change setting, and click on the run this program as an administrator and just click on the OK button and that's it. After that, you need to go to options, click on the trust center settings, click on the external content. Click on enable all data connection. If you already have enabled, then it's okay. You can skip this process or click on the enable all data connections. Here also enable automatic update, enable, click everything enable and just click OK. If you already have, you can skip this process. Once you are done, you are ready. Your Fyers One will look like this or it will have a white theme. Or it will look like this. You can just click on this and right click on it and click on option chain. Once you will have this page, click on this book page or switch the view to non-graphic and click on the all data. From strikes you will need all data, so click on all. Once you will have this, make sure that you create your template, what columns you require to copy, right? Every time, once you will create a sheet based on that, you will have to keep the same columns every time. So first, here you select your columns and the sequence. Once you will have a column selected, click on OK. Now, here you click on and just select the call. Once you will have a call sequence, open a new Excel sheet. On the top right ribbon, you will see a link to Excel. Click on that. You will see all calls are selected. On right hand side, you will see the columns which are visible on your terminal. Click on the OK button. Go to your Excel book and click Ctrl V, or you can do paste. Right click and paste. It will take some time and you will see the data is getting updated. It will get delayed if you have a slower computer. You need a good RAM and good processing time and good broadband width. So as you can see, the data is getting updated. So now we'll go and select put side. So now uncheck the call and click on the put. We'll do the same process. All P's are selected. The columns which we require is selected. Okay. So what columns I have is strike price, option type, OI change, OI change percentile, traded volume, last traded price, price change percentage, price change compared to the previous close. and number of contracts open. So that's it. We have copied this. We'll come here and we will just come here and click on this and we'll paste it. And we'll give some time to update. And as you can see, now we have a complete option chain of current expiry here in my Excel. So now we'll follow the process. What we have been doing it with the NSE data, we'll use the same process, right? So now we already have a NSE data. Now we will need a LTP price of a Nifty and Nifty future contracts so that we can figure out our Excel can link and map to the ATM strike. So for that, we'll again come back to this sheet and we'll click right click on this and then we'll go to view. Once we'll have this, we'll click on link to Excel. We will uncheck all the symbols and we'll just need a Nifty 50 LTP price and we'll hit OK. Once you click OK, come back to your Excel, down underneath and paste it. So now as you can see, we have a LTP ready with us. So what we'll do is we'll come here. We'll see C104. So now we have a LTP price of Nifty. So now we will need a future contract prices. So we'll once again go to Fyers. We'll right click here and we'll click on the future. There's some bug here, but you can just link to the Excel and click OK. I keep unnecessary things unchecked because I don't want beta prices and all. So you can do it as per your requirement. Just check only the data you require and hit OK. And just go to underneath and paste. Now you can see the last traded price, the change percentile, average traded price, and traded volumes is getting updated. So now we have made data connections to our Excel sheet. Now remaining process is going to be the same process what we have done with the our NSE data. So I would request you to watch the NSE video, how I have made and mapped the data and used the VBA connections to plot every 5 minute change in OI. So you can manipulate this data as per your requirement. If you face any challenges to make the sheet, please comment below. I will make a dedicated video on step-by-step process to create a OI sheet, how we have been using it with the NSE data. This template sheet, what I have been using it, I'll share it on my Telegram channel. You can download and use it. Thank you for watching this video. Keep sharing love and sharing your knowledge with others. Thank you so much.